Good morning, coffee drinkers. It is.
It's Chelsea vlog day. I'm gonna kind of do a little Chelsea Q&A. You guys have had a lot of questions about how we met and what I do and the fact that I'm a bass player too and what that's like dating a bass god, as we all know. So I'm gonna give you some insight into all of that. But first of all, here's our day.
Hey, I'm just happy to be in my own vlog for once.
Is that the real motive behind Chelsea Vlog Day?
206 episodes.
You get to be the star?
Before I got to be the star of the vlog.
You think you're going to be the star, but I'm just going to have the camera on me all day.
This is not starting out the right way.
How was your stay? Everything
all good,
okay?
Yeah.
It's great.
Sometimes Janek takes reload, and when I don't take reload, it becomes a bit of a problem. So I've been begging Janek to take me to a really old cemetery ever since we got to Europe, because this is where the history comes from, right? And of course the one we pull off to go to,
I screwed up.
I mean,
there's nothing older than like 1950 here.
Yeah.
And really, so we were looking for like 950.
Yeah, exactly. But the road signs have promised me a castle, and I haven't seen a castle since I got here. So that's exciting, and we'll hope that it's a real old castle and not like, you know, a new Disney castle. That was the first time you've done that.
First time.
Trip, so good job.
And I was doing it to try so you could get the shot of the castle road sign. It's kind of a castle, a little one. And here we have the classic penis in a condom.
Okay, no, this is my vlog. We don't make penis jokes in my vlog.
All this space and no tennis court. I mean, come on.
You're so predictable.
Yeah.
So I'm a little sad because they won't let us inside the castle.
Oh yeah, that's right.
But it's really pretty.
We came out here on a whim, right? Just to, let's go for an adventure. And it did say open.
It did. It said open.
And then as we went to hand them our money, we were informed it's not open. Well, the grounds are open, but not the castle, so.
But it's gorgeous. And as I just told Janek, one day I'll own one, and then I can go in it whenever I want, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely not a Disney castle. That's a real castle. We made it to Glasgow, and this is the first thing we find, a TARDIS. The doctor wasn't here though, Janek looked. We also got some chips, they're freaking amazing, and we're about to go check out this gorgeous cathedral.
See, Chelsea's doing the vlog, so I gotta hold the hair, otherwise you get this, which is not great, so I'm gonna do this.
We are at the Glasgow Necropolis. It's really stunning here. And this way are some beautiful graves, giant monuments, but when you look this way, pretty crazy. Pretty sure we saw Glasgow today.
Yeah. And we've got an hour left before sound check. We're right on schedule.
I hope it's not too loud out here, guys. Someone has decided to move their entire apartment across from my vlog shoot. How dare they? But I decided to enjoy some coffee with you this morning because I drink coffee, unlike some people. I'm gonna do a little Chelsea Q&A. You guys have had a lot of questions about how we met and what I do and the fact that I'm a bass player too and what that's like dating a bass god, as we all know. So I'm gonna give you some insight into all of that. Janek and I met about 7.5 years ago, maybe. He moved here, or not here, we're in Scotland. Anyway, he moved to Los Angeles, where I'm from. I would go to his gig every month. It's actually so shy. When I went to Janek's gigs, I refused to introduce myself. I would just show up to the gig and walk out the door afterwards and not say a word to him. And this had happened so many consecutive months in a row that one gig, Janek decided to walk up to me and say, "Hey, you've been at every one of my shows for like a year now. Do you want to tell me your name or something?" And I think I kind of choked out, "Hi, I'm Chelsea. I'm a big fan," or whatever. Luckily, he's the super nice, outgoing, talkative guy that he is, and we quickly became friends. Obviously, that was a very long time ago. We were both seeing other people. And then this year at NAMM, there's a big bass bash show. I was there hanging with Ruslan. And Ruslan was playing that show with Janek. As we walked out, he asked for my number. What do I do? I'm a bass player. If you didn't already know that. I started playing violin when I was about 4 years old, switched to bass when I was about 13. My dad is a jazz drummer, and I'd just been around jazz my whole life. All of my dad's friends are jazz musicians, and I was kind of sick of not being able to join in on that fun on the violin. My dad made me listen to endless amounts of Jean-Luc Ponty before I switched to bass because he was so convinced that I was going to be a violin player. Side note, my dad didn't want me to be a musician at all. He steered me in any direction that wasn't music. Not because he doesn't love what he does, but I think he's known the business for a really long time, knows how difficult it is, knows that you kind of need to have a tough skin. And I think he just didn't want to subject me to that. But to his chagrin, I and my brother are both musicians. Whoops, sorry, Dad. So yeah, I switched to bass around 12. So it's just, hate this. So I switched to bass around 13. It wasn't instant love. I have really tiny hands, I think, as we've established. But the more I started listening to who would become my heroes, I think the very first time I knew that I needed to play the bass for the rest of my life, I was watching a live concert of Rite of Strings, which is Al Di Meola, Jean-Luc Ponty, and Stanley Clarke. And we were watching it for the purpose of me trying to become a jazz violinist. And I saw Stanley Clarke play, and that was it for me. I knew that the violin was going to be a thing of the past, and bass needed to be my future.
Today is 100% Chelsea's vlog. Please don't get me wrong, I'm not trying to step on her toes, but she also wasn't going to come back here, and I wanted to capture this for you guys because it's one of the more unique green rooms. It is actually green. It's very rare that the green room is actually green, but it's also one of the unique green rooms because to get to it, I have to come through this. It's freezing in here. This is where we're in a basement. This is where they keep all the beer for the bar upstairs. Hey, look at this. Okay, that's my 30-second hijack over. I'm sorry, babe. Did not mean to hijack. Just wanted to show everyone what was really going on back here.
Short interruption by Janek. He's done sound checking, so we're going to go get dinner in a minute. Whoop. Camera falling. Fail. I started listening to a lot of Ron Carter, a lot of Paul Chambers, Christian McBride, but the same time that I started bass, a lot of girls actually also started to come to the forefront. Tal Wilkenfeld, Esperanza Spalding, and it showed me that I could do it too, and I'm sure all you girls out there kind of know this is a really male-heavy industry, and that actually works really well for my personality. Almost all of my friends are guys. It just kind of goes that way when you're an instrumentalist in the jazz world, I think. But at the same time, it's nice to see other girls that are really doing it, and not because they're girls, 100% because they can actually play. I've always been adamant that that is where my career needs to come from. And I really respect girls that put that first. So I'm sure a lot of you guys are wondering what it's like to date Janek Gwizdala. Let me tell you, it's pretty crazy. Just try to imagine one of your favorite musicians of all time. I'm going to assume that you are a straight male and that your favorite musician of all time is also a straight male, but pretend they're a girl, and not just that, but like a really hot girl. You've seen them play a million times, and they walk up to you after one of their shows and ask you to be their boyfriend. That's kind of what happened to me. Janek's such an amazing guy, and I never considered that side of our relationship because, you know, he's a great bass player, and I loved that part of our relationship, and I really didn't want to lose that musical side of it and possibly risk that by dating. But we just get along so well that it's 100% worth it. I think I connect a lot with some of you people who leave comments on the blog because Janek really does have this crazy work ethic. I think he gets really sensitive when people say that he is such a talented bass player because he knows how hard he had to work for that. But I think that is what's so unique about him. His work ethic is unheard of, and I see it on a daily basis. It's completely real. He practices for hours. He plays tennis and works out for hours. And I am just a normal person. I like to drink coffee. I like to watch Netflix. I also play the bass, and I do love to practice and work hard and do all of those things. I'm a bit of a workaholic myself. But to date someone who is just that motivated all the time, ambulance. But to date someone who is that motivated literally all of the time, I thought would become completely overwhelming. I thought that I would start to feel bad about myself, to feel like I wasn't good enough. He's such a ridiculous player, and I am a bass player, you know? I'm just a bass player. I'm not some famous, huge force of the electric bass. But he makes it just such a non-issue. He's such an amazingly nice guy, you know, and he treats anyone that comes in his path like that. He doesn't care where you are on your journey, just as long as you're trying to get somewhere. Even when you're not, he's so supportive of the fact that I don't, much like I'm sure a lot of you, I have no idea what I'm doing with my career. It's still kind of at the beginning of it. It's really hard to convince yourself to keep going, I think, when you're not as naturally motivated as Janek is. And when you don't have the people around you who are either doing it themselves or telling you that you can do it, darn right almost impossible to keep going. So to have that kind of support group now is just amazing. I have no idea if you will ever see Janek and I play together. I'm sure it'll happen. I don't know if it'll happen on camera. We have actually never played together on or off camera. I'm sure it'll happen, maybe. It's me that's holding it back, not him, but probably someday. Just so you guys know, I never in my life thought I would be making a vlog. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to leave them below. I think we have a gig to go to right now, which is pretty exciting. We're at the Hug and Pint tonight. We're heading straight in there. I think we're gonna go grab some dinner and then go play some music. So I'll see you guys later. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, so it's kind of fitting that we've swapped our roles. Chelsea goes back to the base. I go back to the vlogging camera. We're in Edinburgh.
Somehow.
Yeah, somehow we're in Edinburgh. After the gig, it's like after midnight. I've dumped the footage from Chelsea's vlogging day, and we'll edit it shortly. But we're exhausted.
Oh, yeah.
It's been a really long day. We got a lot done.
Today's vlog is done. We'll see you tomorrow. Good night.
See ya.